so much. Welcome. This will be a deep dive, or more like a snorkeling. We will now look a bit under the hood, but this morning we were focusing on the user side, and now we will look a bit more on the developer side and a little bit under the hood. So Wolith is set up as a GitHub organization, and it has several like modularity. It has several repositories. One is the Wolith, that's the app basically. Ketherium is a library, a Kotlin, this is all you see Kotlin libraries, a Kotlin Ethereum library that I use in Wolith, and also in Wolith Push and other apps. That's the website, so if you find a typo, that's where you can correct that. There might be some. KHEX for extension functions for hexadecimal stuff, and KCAG, for the hashes. You need that all the time. You saw a lot of Kotlin. Now I have to describe why did I use Kotlin. And it is basically because Kotlin is an awesome language. It makes you a happy and more productive programmer. Who in this room knows Kotlin? Like, I have to get the audience with, oh, that's way too little. So Kotlin is a language from JetBrains. And JetBrains, a lot of people of you might already know, because they are providing an IDE many of you developers might already use. It's IntelliJ IDEA. And IntelliJ IDEA is basically the base for a lot of IDEs out there. They are really good. And Kotlin, you see how nice that fits from the logos? So that's it fits really well. And what you see also here, it gets really traction. It's a quite new language. But you see it gets traction, it's going up here. And you see other languages, like this Clojure thing, is going down. And for example, there are other clients implemented in Clojure and it's going down. Kotlin is going up, that's really good. So, and here you also see why. Because at this year's Google I/O, Google made it official, that it's now an official language for Android. And before, like I'm doing Kotlin way longer than Google was announcing it, but before it was always big companies were like, ooh, we cannot use it because Google might decide to like fight against it. But since Google made it official, you see the adoption got really high. That's where we are now. And I'm attending a lot of like Android conferences, and now it's more and more talks about Kotlin. Kotlin is everywhere. And it's a really nice, concise language. And it's, the nice thing is it compiles to Java, and Java 6 bytecode. And that's basically why I can use it for Android development. And that's really nice. But it's also nice because it also can compile to JavaScript. That's quite new and quite unstable yet, but it's going there. And also to Kotlin native, so that means embedded machines, and so in the future you can also use it for that. And then it's quite fast. So, but I'm just using the Java part now, but in the future we might use it for, so like we have type safety, you know, JavaScript, no type safety, bad, really, really bad. So, Ketherium, so I was, I like to write a library there. And it doesn't contain much now, but it's all that, I'm using that all in Wolith. And that could be building blocks to in the end, because that's my end vision, to also have an official implementation of Ethereum in Kotlin, but it's way off. But now it's like collecting all the building blocks, and then that gets easier, because if all the building blocks are already there, you just have to connect them basically. It's easy, right? So, but I can't do that alone, so that's also why I'm here. But advertisement, if you want to join, it's all open source, pull requests welcome. So there's already RLP encoding. I'm basically also using that for Trezor support in Wolith. There is BIP44 also for the Trezor support. ERC55 address checksums are in there, all nice with tests and stuff. ERC67 URLs, ERC67, again, very important. Don't use plain addresses, use ERC67, or the new standard that is emerging. Find more information on wallet.org, there's a blog. It already contains some crypto stuff, hash functions, KCAG, use KCAG all over the place in Ethereum, and basically models you can use over a lot of projects. Because this way, we can share code. Because as good programmers, we want to write dry code. Don't repeat yourself, right? We don't want to use wet code, which is like, wet is nice in the ocean, but wet is bad in code, you know? So Ethereum is used by Wallis. Then also Issueth, that's another project that is in the context of Wallis. I will talk about that a little bit later. Then also Wallis FCM is Firebase Cloud Messaging, unfortunately some centralized shit. But for now, sometimes you have to make small steps. You know, you cannot do everything full decentralization. You have to make some shortcuts. That's a shortcut now. In the end, I really love what Status is doing there with the decentralized push, but unfortunately it's not yet there, but I hope for the future there. And then it's also used by Heimdall Android. That's a project of Gnosis. It's basically a multi-signature wallet. So, and I all invite you to also use Ethereum in your projects. Try it out, send feedback, extend it, use it, and so on. And then we built the pyramid even higher. Who has attended the talk this morning? Ah, not that many, but there will be a video. Please watch the video because I can't go into details much there because I love to build with building blocks. You know, we need building blocks, small steps, and basically also Wallis then is a building block for another project of mine, PassAndroid, S-Pass, basically a ticket system on top of Wallis, because not every app should have their own light client, because light clients are really, really heavy, and if you have that in all apps, then your phone has no memory anymore. That's bad, and we want that for emerging markets, and they have really, really small devices. And another app of mine, I was writing Satoshi Proof, that's a Bitcoin proof of existence system, and I want to adapt that to Ethereum because that fits way nicer, because at the moment on Bitcoin I'm sending like Satoshis to addresses that don't really exist, and that is the proof basically. And Bitcoin people don't really like that because I'm burning money. I like burning money, it's bad. Bitcoin people don't like it, but for Ethereum it would be much nicer because you can just write the timestamps as data on the chain. And you can get that all via JITPACK. JITPACK is a really nice project to basically get the artifacts for code. And I just have to basically push a tag to GitHub, and then JITPACK is already available on JITPACK. Not like with Maven Central, I have to upload it and bah and foop. So JITPACK is really nice for that. There is one problem though, trust. We are in a security thing here, and if you just trust the artifacts that are coming from JITPACK, bad, because they could basically give you an artifact that is malicious and then that could steal your keys. And I was very clear in the morning, we need open stuff and the keys have to be protected. So there's one nice thing from Whisper Systems. Whisper Systems is basically the foundation behind Signal, and that's Gradle Witness. And basically that proves that the artifacts, by the hash of the artifacts, that these are the right hashes, and you always have to prove basically that the artifacts are right. So I'm using Gradle Witness. When you use Ethereum, don't just use it via JITPACK and trust it. Use Gradle Witness and pin your artifacts. So, and you should also, I see this often in the Ethereum space also, they use stuff from NPM and everywhere that's centralized and that could give you malicious artifacts. So really be careful. And I don't know if something for NPM is existing like that. But you should, because otherwise, wow, we're screwed. Like, woo. I want to talk shortly about Issueth. Perhaps you have heard about Committeth of Status, also a really nice project, and I basically got the idea from that, but I couldn't really use it because it basically wants admin permission for my GitHub, and my GitHub is holy for me, so I didn't want to give them admin permission. And at this year's GitHub Satellite, they were basically introducing GitHub apps that are tied integrations into GitHub, and with that you can really have fine-grained permissions, and I only have to give permissions to reading and writing issues on my repository, so it can't do anything else, it can't do anything with my code, so that's really nice. So I started Issueth for that. And that's a little bit about tokens. I don't want to introduce tokens in my app because I love my users. I want, and I think when I introduce, like, that was a picture of Vlad was posting once, you know, I added tokens to our apps. Great, now we have a lot of money, but bah, it's not less user-friendly. Yeah, don't worry, they will love the tokens, but they will not because it's just annoying. I don't want tokens in my app, but for issue, it's quite nice. You just install it in your GitHub repository, basically, and then the committed like admin access. Wow, bad. But I heard I fixed it now, but I tried it. It was not yet fixed, but that's a problem. I opened the issue there. On issues, you can go to your GitHub repository, press install here, and then basically you can also only do it for some repositories, and here it's only read access to metadata, read and write to issues. That's not that intrusive, right? And then what you just do, you add a bounty label to your issue, and then it's adding this nice ERC-67 QR code there. And then, for example, you could scan it with Wallet and transfer value to that, and then it looks like that. New token transfer on Rinkeby with a value of 1.1 wall. 1.1 wall is basically the Wallet tokens. They are not worth anything yet, but it's the same as with a lot of other tokens. They are not really worth anything. But I will give it to you for fixing issues or opening issues or even just attending. If you approach me, you get basic attention tokens. You know, you visit my talk, so come to me. I give you some tokens. Install the app. They're not yet worth, but they're also on Rinkeby only. Like, why waste money on mainnet? Rinkeby is nice, right? And then, if you close the issue, basically, then I sign, I encrypt the private key for the account. I can read the PGP key for the one who is assigned to this issue. And I encrypt it for him, he can decrypt it and send the money anywhere. That has the really nice advantage that I don't have to spend money in transfer fees. He can do it if he wants. If he doesn't trust me, he transfers it directly, or if he trusts me, he can even leave that. I don't really care, but just I don't want to pay any transfer fees because I like being without money. So, and I hope that changes the situation a bit because that's the current participation of Wallet, and it's mainly me. But some other nice contributors, and thanks to you all. And I wanted to say, this morning I had to really rush to the presentation because I was a bit late there. But thanks to all the contributors, and I hope there will be more contributors in the future. And you all get wall tokens. Wall tokens are nice, even bragging rights, you know? You have wall tokens. Really cool. I also want to say I'm using the new Android architecture components in Wallet. They are really nice. They were also introduced with this year's Google I.O. I really like them. I use a Room for that, Room database, to store all the addresses, to store everything, because it has a really, really nice interface. And you just annotate some DAO methods with your SQL queries, and you can access that stuff really, really easily. It's not yet a release version. It's a release candidate now. But the same, Wolf is still alpha, so when Wolf gets in beta, they will have it released, I think. But it's a really, really nice library, and also use live data from there and all the architecture components. Really, really nice. The Android team really kicks ass. Android is nice. Apple, shit, closed source. Android, open source, nice. That's really dark. That's really bad. These are services that are in Wallet. That's the GetAge. I'm using Go Ethereum, the Go Ethereum team, also nice. I'm at the moment using Go Ethereum for most of the consensus stuff. In the end, I also want to replace it with a real Kotlin implementation because that would be even smaller. At the moment, Wallet is quite big because I have to compile it for all the architectures, but I love the Go team. They are really, really good, and I don't want to care for that at the moment because I'm more I want to have nice user interfaces and stuff like that. That's really dark. That's really bad. Yeah, these are product flavors, basically. So it's for F-Droid. You find the app on F-Droid. And for Amazon, I haven't yet released it. Releasing on Amazon is a real pain in the ass. But I wanted to do it later. But when Wallet isn't better, I will also release it. These are flavors for Amazon, for Google Play. For Google Play, I compile Firebase in there. Firebase is closed source, bad, but on Google, you're fucked anyway. But on, for example, then on F-Droid, I don't compile Firebase in there. Then you have, don't have push messages. I have to finish now. Android Things approached me with that. I'm doing some experiments with Android Things. It's really nice, working and consensus. This is my URL, leakit.de, wallet.org, this, LastPass. Have a nice day.